I'm also not hearing tonight, but I wish to point out one of the reasons I kind of surround my life with it and dedicating and define myself this way is because I'm against poverty. I'm a socialist, a libertarian socialist. I'm an anti-poverty activist. And I think, look at the numbers. Just look at the numbers of pills alone. Ignore alcohol, tobacco, caffeine, chocolate, the competitors to cannabis. Just look at pills. $364 billion globally, 180 billion in North America, wasted on pills. I bet you 99 to 100% of them can be replaced with herbs if we start to really study the herbs, if we put as much money into studying the herbs as we did on pills. So I think I'm ready to carve out. I hate it when I hear growers and dealers say, I want to keep it legal or at least be printed because I don't want to keep making money off it. Think of the money you can make carving up $180 billion pill industry for yourself. Half that would be cannabis-based medicines, half that would be opiate or other-based botanical medicines that we could be supplying ourselves in our window boxes and breeding. And I'm in it as an anti-poverty activist because I think anyone who contributes to society deserves vacations and children and all the other things I can't afford right now, dental. Right? Because I'm a wage slave, you know? So I think that that's what cannabis would lead to, is a huge ma-and-pa cottage industry with all sorts of herbal medicines taking our medical economy back from the pharmaceutical industry. That's another reason. And then the third reason, aside from the environment and poverty, and that I haven't heard tonight, but I still kind of hold this as an ideal, is that human beings could evolve beyond the need for scapegoats to attack huge groups of harmless people to distract from the real crimes going on. And I think that we could do this one of two ways. We could do this the Emily Murphy style way, or we could keep hammering away with them on principle, like the Danes did with the Nazis. The Emily Murphy got great power for women. Women got a chance to vote, and they could be judges. But at what price? She handed them another scapegoat. Here we, emancipated women, that's terrific. And then the price for that, the price they asked, I'm sure, was that giving someone else to beat up, point of finger. We can't be making that same mistake that Emily Murphy made. We cannot hand them another scapegoat, which means we have to win this argument, not on economics, not waiting for the government to go broke, and need us, finally. By then it could be too late, environmentally and socially. What we need is to keep looking them in the eye, saying they're absolutely harmless. There is no evidence of inherent harm from cannabis. All the harm comes from prohibition and ignorance. And you can't prove otherwise. And the Supreme Court refused to prove otherwise. And everyone knows now this is the age of information. By golly, we have no excuses other than to press them on those facts. We're harmless, we should not be harmed ourselves. The 5-cent fine, I don't want to pay a $200 fine for not harming someone, just having an intelligent preference for botanical medicines over the pill. I don't want to be harmed, 5-cent fine. What I want is compassion clubs to be funded by Medicare. I think it'd be brilliant. I think what Rosie said is we need to get all on the same page and move forward. So I'm saying let's argue about what our bottom line is, all agree on that, and then take it to the NDP down there and say, yeah, man, cafes, you remember cafes? The NDP, they need us more than we need them. They were founded by farmers, the CCF. What could you do more for the farmers and give them the number one cash crop? And they're anti-poverty activists. What was reminding them of the billions and billions of dollars wasted on pills? And alcohol and tobacco, too, which are harder to get into, need a greater amount of investment to sell alcohol and tobacco. But anyone who can grow good weed. It's not rocket science. I'm learning that anyone can grow good opium, too. It's really easy to make it. It's grow poppies, cut poppies, scrape, smoke. I couldn't believe how, and then you don't spend your money on these horrible pharmaceutical companies that just take that money and start other infinite wars with it. So I hope we can learn like that. What else? I want you all to come to Vancouver, check out my school. It's the Herb School, calling it for short. It's the Vancouver School of Drug War History and Organic Cultivation. That's what we tell bureaucrats. And I want you to learn, if you can, these are $3 to $10 for free, because I'm not, you know, if you want to read this, I want to give it to you. But it'll teach you about your history, and then we all become good days. We all become principled, nonviolent, pestering, constantly hammering away at the Germans to the south. And then they will, as Hannah Arendt so eloquently put it, their resolve will melt like butter in the sun. Because we have the truth on our side, and we are living in the age of information, and we have no excuse but to keep hammering away with that truth until they melt. Because I'm not melting, I'm not going away, I'm here, I'm high. Get used to me, and I'm also here for us, too, so. Now, I hope if there's any, if there's any policemen recording this in the audience tonight, I hope they learned something. And it is my sincere wish that we crash the NDP party, and kind of mingle in there. Start lighting joints up and pressing Jack for his promise. I can get through the building over. We'd be too hard for us to infiltrate and put some seeds in their mind. Because really, we're not asking Jack to legalize. I know he can't do that. He's just a small party. But he has access to the mass media. And ultimately, this is simply because we don't really have the guns to defend ourselves against the police. This is really a dignity game. In Vancouver, we lecture the cops. Never comes the other way. If there's a parent complaining about marijuana smoke, we go up to them and say, are you concerned over harm or disobedience? And then they stop complaining. We just take all the dignity we deserve, and we demand equal rights of caffeine people. And we developed this little bubble of tolerance, and we want it to grow from Vancouver and just spread out all over Canada, and eventually, after 2 years of incredible soft drug tourism, the U.S. caves and they say, well, we're tired of the Canadians making all the money in, well, Nevada can have it. And that's how it's going to be. It's not going to be 10 years to 20 years when we're broke and there's no more trees left, and we have died of oil wars and all sorts of nasty instant war nastiness. No, it's going to be in 6 months to a year when we all use our spines. Thank you.
Pot people need to use their spines, their hearts, their passions, and their brains. And pot people have the best of all these worlds.